The Tom Woods Show, episode 1130, bonus episode.
Prepare to set fire to the index card of allowable opinion. Your daily dose of liberty education starts here. The Tom Woods Show.
Hi, everybody. Tom Woods here. Very glad to be joined once again by Michael Chaney, master of affiliate marketing and championship cyclist. This guy is very, very impressive all around. His writing, his accomplishments, his sort of rags to riches story, or let's just say being just a middling desk job guy who dreamed of something more. And man, did he ever get it. He is just on top of the world in terms of producing products in the internet marketing niche. These are products, by the way, that have helped me become much more effective in the affiliate sphere, just because I do what he teaches. There are only two people in the world I have ever actually given a testimonial for, because I felt like I was just obligated to, because they've helped me so much. One of them is Ben Settle, who's been a guest two or three times on the show. I'll be getting him back again soon because he's great to talk to. And the other one's Michael Chaney, because I'm able to do really, really well against people who have 10 times the audience I have, because I just do what Michael teaches. And he's got an interesting lifestyle, and he just has a lot to teach about all this, about building up an extra income stream or making things work online or being effective with email or writing advertising copy, whatever it is. He's been through it. He knows it. He's been doing this for years and years, at least since the year 2000, and really got his start even before that. So very important, interesting guy to talk to, and I always like to have the opportunity to grab a few minutes of his time. Michael, welcome back.
Hey, how you doing?
I couldn't be better. I am so interested to talk to you. I love following your Facebook page. I don't know what to tell you. I like to see the funny things you say. I like to see the success that people are having who are doing your stuff. And I always click like. Like every time somebody earns a big commission through you, I always click like, because how could you not like that? You know, you'd have to be a terrible person not to like that. So I do want to make sure everybody gets who you are. I mean, you are, in a way, you're like Ben Settle in that people either love you or they hate you. That's how they feel about me. Nobody's lukewarm about Tom Woods. It's either love or hate. You have a distinct style in your marketing and in your emails, and that style includes a lot of winning. You're very successful at what you do in producing your own products and supporting other people's products. So I want people to get that you are a big, big name. You're one of the big sellers on one of the biggest platforms in this whole area of internet marketing. So it's great to talk to you. You got started. We talked about this last time you're on. You got started. Let's say it was not always sunshine and lollipops. It did take a lot of work, but now you're in a position where you can enjoy a lifestyle that most people can only dream of. And I want to start off actually by talking about your cycling. You're a basically champion cyclist, which requires a lot of practice every day, which means you can't be working all the time. In fact, I had a problem. I couldn't get one of my bike tires properly inflated. So I made you a video and sent it to you, you know, across the pond. And you wrote, you made me a video with your kids in it, coming back to me as to what I should do. But anyway, let's start with that. Last year, you were like 35th in the world in your class.
Yeah, that's right. It's become a major passion for me, cycling. I mean, I've been doing it for a number of years and started competing seriously, really, just for the first year last year, maybe 2 years ago. I'm kind of losing track now. But I was fortunate enough. I qualified for the World Championships last year and went over to those. It's my first kind of real major event, and it's people from all over the world, as you can imagine. They have qualifiers in all different continents, and the fastest people that qualify get to the World Championships, and then you compete there to be, you know, the best in the world. And yeah, I was delighted to get ranked 35 currently in the world in my age category, and I'm now gunning this year to break into the top 20. That's my goal for this season.
And so I've been following you on Facebook, and I know that it's been cold over there, and you're in Scotland?
That's right, yeah, northeast Scotland. It's been grim. Yeah, it's been the coldest, longest winter ever. it's been pretty crazy. But I've been getting out. Basically, I'm going through what I call HTFU, which stands for harden the, well, you can guess what the F is, harden the
right.
the frick up, let's just say, or harden the frick university. So it basically means, what this involves is me going out on my bike for an average of about 2 hours every day, 6 days a week, whatever the weather, from mid-October all the way through till the end of March. So yeah, being able to do that then puts me in a great position of kind of strength and fitness to then take on the season and hopefully get some good results and some more silverware this year.
I've seen photos of you with your bike covered in snow, and then when it just became impassable and you couldn't possibly ride, you started hiking just to make sure you were out there doing something physical. And you and I, we were chatting through the Voxer app.
That's
you remember
it.
That? And so you sent me a photo of you just out there. And I just said, "What? You're crazy, man. What's up with you?" But it's part of your whole... Well, if I say shtick, it'll sound artificial, but it's not. On your Facebook thing, you're always drawing comparisons between your commitment and dedication to the cycling and your commitment and dedication to your business.
Yeah, I mean, the two things go hand in hand to me. It's not, you know, there's a group of people in business and in internet marketing especially that have this mindset that if you graft, if you're a hustler and you're always working, you're always in front of the computer and you're always doing 12 hours a day, that somehow that's a good thing. And to my mind, it's not. You know, you can't be good at one thing, you know, or bad at one thing and good at everything else. You know, there's a common denominator in your life. And if, you know, how you do one thing is how you do everything. So you can't be, you can't kind of say, oh yeah, I'm really going to crush it online and crush it in business. But, you know, your kind of personal life is a mess, or, you know, the state of your house is a mess, or, you know, you're really unhealthy, or, you know, it doesn't work like that. To me, these feed off each other, the commitment and the discipline, and the mental strength that the cycling gives me feeds back into the business, and vice versa. They're basically the same thing. It's, you know, I'm not a workaholic. I'm not a fitnessaholic. I'm basically a balanceaholic. You know, I've got my family, which first and foremost, I've got my fitness and the cycling. I've got my business, and I'm balancing all these things and trying to excel and be the best that I can in all areas, rather than trying to, you know, sacrifice any of them, thinking that that's what you need to do. You don't have to sacrifice things. You shouldn't have to sacrifice things anyway to be good in one area in your life. That's my theory, and that's what I'm trying to live by. And yeah, and that's what I'm kind of trying to teach people on Facebook as well with the cycling stuff, and saying, look, I'm not, you know, I might be, you know, one of the best sellers on the internet and, you know, get all these awards and, you know, literally make millions of dollars a year. But, you know, half the time I'm out on my bike or I'm with my kids. You know, it's not about working every hour that God sends. It's about working smarter, leveraging and all that kind of stuff, which, you know, we may get into later.
Well, I'll tell you, my listeners probably are tired of hearing about it, but I used to be the person you just described who thought that every moment that I had should be devoted to productivity defined in terms of work. So if I'm standing in line for 10 minutes, I've got to be working on some project in that 10 minutes. Now, of course, I don't,
right.
I still want to read the news at least while I'm waiting in line, but I would begrudge myself just simple pleasures because I had to be working, constantly working. And my life was completely out of balance. My office was a mess. Everything's a mess. You know, the priorities are all out of whack, but I was producing a lot. My output was amazing. And I thought that was good enough. And I'm just tired of living that way. And I'm definitely getting into the kind of groove that you're in terms of balance, because that is what you ought to be striving for. And I can get why the first few years you work at something, maybe you go overboard and you're really dedicated to it, but that can't be the goal. That's the transition that you're, that's what you need to do maybe to get to the goal, but you can't forget the goal, which is
to have a
happy life, which has to be defined in terms other than just work.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And I've gone through the same thing. You know, I think a lot of us have gone through that through necessity, as you say, to begin with, to try and get the momentum going, to try and, you know, get the rocket ship of your, you know, entrepreneurial dream off the ground. You know, you've got to put a lot of energy into it to break free of gravity. But then somehow quite a lot of us get trapped on that and we're kind of dragged along for the ride, you know, and before we know it, you know, we're in, you know, we're just struggling for air and struggling for oxygen because this thing's just taken off and we can't, you know, it's beyond our control. So what I see, you know, regularly with a lot of the marketers online and a lot of the, you know, the internet entrepreneurs especially, is they cannot escape. They can't escape their business. You know, they don't really have a business. They've really just got a job that's worse than the job that they had before, you know, because they're working longer hours. They don't take time off. And when they do, or if they do take time off, they, you know, they don't get paid. The money stops, you know, and that's not a business. That's just a job. So I've seen that a lot, you know, talking to people, even some of the big names, you'd be surprised to know that they kind of feel trapped on this hamster wheel of, you know, appearing like it's successful from the outside looking in. And, you know, as you said before, the productivity is there and maybe even to a certain extent, the money may be there, but the balance and the time freedom to actually go off and do what they want in their life, which I'm guessing is why they started this in the first place, is just not present at all. And it's not through choice. It's through the animal, the beast that they've created. It's through the type of business that they've created that demands so much on their time. They cannot escape and they can't actually get the time that they should get as an entrepreneur, which is, as you and I know, and many people know, is far more valuable than the money.
And in fact, I think sometimes even when folks like this do manage to get away, they don't really get away because they're frantically checking their emails the whole time they're on vacation. And in fact, that was the thing that made me sit up and take notice that maybe I hadn't fully completed my own journey because I couldn't totally unplug even for a couple of days if I went out of town for the weekend. I couldn't totally unplug. I had to check in because maybe there's something that needs my attention. So I finally decided, look, I need to train people who can substitute for my attention. If I need to go out town somewhere, I know that my email's being managed. I know that, I even have somebody who maintains my email. Now, not the address that you have. You have the private bat phone to me.
I was going to say, like, who have I been talking to all this time? Right.
Sure, sounds like Woods, but yeah. there is the bat phone to me, but the email address that most people find for me when they search is now monitored by an assistant who knows 98% of the time what to do in certain situations so that I don't have to worry. Right. And I can actually legitimately take the time off. Whereas I've talked to some of the very people maybe you have in mind who say, oh my gosh, how do you do that? I couldn't possibly. I say, yeah, I haven't checked email. And I haven't checked my email account in like a month. They say, what? I couldn't go 10 hours without checking it. But it's because I've made it a business that runs according to my desires, and those include a desire for inner peace and not constantly, not the frenetic rat race all the time. Because you can have a rat race even when you're working for yourself. You can, as you said, you can keep yourself on that wheel, but then you have to liberate yourself from that wheel. All right, now I'm going to talk about something that is totally personal, and it's outrageous that I would even ask you this, but but given that I do follow you on Facebook and you're not exactly shy about talking about it, I feel emancipated to ask it of you, and that is, give people a sense of, you know, how much money you make. I never asked anybody that question, but you know, part of the proof you need to give people when you teach them things is that I do this too, and it brings results. And so one of the ways you do that in this field, like if it were fitness, well, one thing you could say is I win a lot of races. Right, well, if it's internet marketing, it has to be I make a lot of sales. It has to be that.
Yeah, it's a weird thing in a couple of ways. One, because it kind of, you know, as you say, a lot of people don't talk about, particularly in Britain, like, you know, you know pretty much, or will know surely, you know, kind of the kind of money that I'm earning, but a lot of my friends don't know how much money I'm earning. It's not something that people openly talk about, but in the business that we're in, which is, you know, making money online, as you say, you have to show that what you're doing works and that, you know, the methods that you're teaching people do work. So yeah, we talk in this industry, we talk about money a lot. Not to brag or to show off, but just to say, look, this is effective. This is what we are doing in our business, and these are the results that we're getting. So, yeah, I mean, in terms of money, I track it on a daily basis. I've got a spreadsheet in terms of money coming in from various sources, the various different funnels and kind of pipelines of income that we have. And yeah, I mean, I can give you the numbers. I mean, in January 2018, we brought in $141,000 in January 2018. February, we brought in $144,000. This month, obviously, at time of recording, just shy of $100,000. So probably on track to, yeah, probably do about the same $130,000, $140,000 a month. We've got costs coming out of that, but they're fairly minor. I would say they're probably about 10% at the very most. So yeah, profit-wise, I mean, we're kind of clearing, $130,000, $120,000 a month right now. So yeah, it's pretty good income. I don't like to spend too long thinking about it because it's kind of bizarre to me. It's almost, you know, weird that it's got to this level. And, you know, I don't really focus on that. It's not, you know, I'm not doing this for the money. To me, it's more, you know, it's same as cycling, right? I've got a coach for cycling. He always tells me the same thing. Whenever I, you know, say the race is coming up, and I say to him, John, you know, what should I do? I'm like, in this race, should I focus on this competitor, or should I, you know, I'm trying to win this, you know, I've got this trophy, I want to get on the podium, how can I get on the podium? And he's like, Michael, calm down, don't focus on the outcome, okay, focus on the process, right? Don't focus on the outcome, focus on the process. And that's what I'm doing in my business. As I said before, these two things now in my life are firing off each other, and I'm taking lessons that I'm learning in cycling, applying to business and vice versa. So the money that I look at coming in every day, I'm like, wow, that's awesome. And obviously I'm very grateful for it. And I, you know, spend some of it, I save a bunch of it, use some of it for family, you know, obviously put some to good causes and everything else. But I'm not obsessing over that. What I am obsessing over is the process of the business that I've created and continue to develop that's enabled that, you know, has made that possible. So trying to improve that process, trying to grow it, trying to make it even more streamlined, even more hands-free so that I can, you know, go from just working, you know, sort of 4 or 5 hours a day, 5 days a week, which is what I work at the moment, to, you know, to even less. So that's the, yeah, that's the income that it's generating at the moment. But as I say, for me, as great as that is, and I am very grateful for, you know, for every dollar that comes in, I'm not, you know, it's a kind of a weird thing. I think when you get to a certain level of income and when you've managed to generate so much money, it actually, surreally, that's the first time you actually start being able to ask the questions that are really important in life. Like, you know, up until that point, you're like, oh my God, how can I pay the mortgage? How can I put food on the table? How can I pay the bills? You know, how can I get this car? How can I get this house? How can I buy this cool stuff? Once you've done all that, then you're like, your mind kind of becomes freed up. And you're like, actually, none of that actually matters. What really matters is, you know, how can I leave a legacy? How can I make a difference? How can I add value? How can I change people's lives? But you can't really think in that altruistic way unless you're Gandhi. You know, until you've freed yourself from the financial constraints that this world puts upon us to put food on the table and pay the mortgage and everything else. So, yeah, it's kind of a surreal situation. I'm thinking and spending less time thinking about money right now and making more than I ever have before. It's just one of those bizarre things.
Yeah. But I understand the logic of it for sure. Now, the thing is, with me, I did start off with a bit of an audience because I wrote some best-selling books, and then I didn't just write the books. I then took advantage of YouTube to spread the word more about my books and to do a lot of public speaking. And so it wasn't like I wrote the books and then automatically an audience developed. I had to cultivate that audience. And only after years of that did it occur to me to create a product other than a book, namely a digital product, an online product, which was courses that are kind of that for which the books are just a springboard. Mm. And so if you like my books, maybe you like my courses. So this is outside of the internet marketing area, although I use my internet marketing knowledge to market these sorts of courses and products.
Right.
But some people may say, all right, Wood, so you've had some success because, well, you know, you wrote a New York Times bestselling book or a couple of them, and not all of us have done that. So the question becomes, if I, you know, Mr. X, want to do what you do or Cheney does, and you can work from your laptop and work on the beach or work 4 hours a day or whatever. It's easy for you to say, but the trouble is I don't have this built-in advantage that you have. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, how do you, because you right now, you didn't start off with a big advantage, but right now you have a huge mailing list. You have name recognition. You have JVs who would, you know, slit the throats of their, you know, their second cousin just to be able to promote your stuff. You know, so what do you say to somebody who says, I haven't got any of that?
Well, you don't need it. You don't need it, at least at first. I mean, obviously it's great to have, right? And it's, you're going to get better results when you get to that point, but you don't need it. I mean, think about this. When I started out doing this back in the year 2000, there weren't really any so-called gurus. I mean, there were probably two or three named internet marketers that exist, and the title internet marketer didn't really exist back then. They were just these guys online that were making big money. And I was like, oh, wow, they're cool. I wonder how they did that. It was like literally like two or three people. So now there's a lot of people out there that are being successful with this and training and giving information and teaching people how to do it. So the shortcut is to leverage other people's results, right? So people always say, well, how am I going to, for example, how am I going to get people on my list, right? If I want to try and build a mailing list, why would they come onto my list, or why would they visit my website? Well, if you don't have your own results, so you don't have your own track record, then you can use somebody else's, right? Simple. You basically learn something, you invest in a program from somebody, you learn something, and many of these programs have what's called an affiliate program, where if you promote that program to other people, you will get paid money, normally 50% of the money. So what you can do is you can buy a program, you can learn it, you can study it, and you can say, okay, I know this stuff now. Here's what I know. This is cool. I didn't know this, didn't know how to do XYZ. Now I know how to do it. This guy taught me, look at his results. He did this, this, and this with, you know, using this method. Come over here and I'll show you how it works. So you're not sharing your results. It's not like you've made, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars or millions of dollars, or whatever. You're just leveraging somebody else's success and getting paid to, you know, refer them business. Because you're basically saying, look, this guy has the credibility. You're basically like, you know, making the introductions. You know, you're like the middleman to the people that don't know that that information is out there and exists. Right? Because there's tons of people, thousands and thousands of people every day that go online and are looking for information, how to do certain things on the internet, you know, how to set up a blog or how to create YouTube videos, or all these different things. And you can find training and programs that show people how to do this, and you can refer them into those programs. Or, so that's one way. You don't need to even learn that stuff. You can just be the conduit to introduce them to these products, because they don't know how to find them, or they don't have the time or willingness to put the legwork in to find them. So you can give them that shortcut and get paid the money to do that. So that's one way. But the other way is you can become what I call this express expert. Now, most people, when they're trying to learn the, you know, the ins and outs of internet marketing, for example, they dot around all the different things that you need to learn. You know, they'll spend some time learning this area, this area, this area. And what ends up happening is they know a little bit about a lot of things, but they don't know a lot about one particular thing. So they're not an expert. They're kind of just not even a jack of all trades. They're just kind of a newbie of all trades. They've got a very thin knowledge of a lot of different things. And that's just human nature. That's what people want to do. They want to learn a little bit about everything. Maybe they get bored or frustrated, so they move on to the next thing. But you can become an express expert just by focusing on one area. So if you just say, okay, I'm going to pick this one area of internet marketing, let's just say it's, I don't know, YouTube, and you just say, okay, for the next couple of weeks, I'm just going to take an hour a day or 30 minutes a day, and I'm just going to learn YouTube. I'm going to learn how to market on YouTube. I'm going to, you know, search on Google for articles. I'm going to go onto YouTube and look at videos that teach you how to market on YouTube. Maybe I'll buy a couple of programs that teach you how to do this. Just 30 minutes a day. For a couple of weeks. Now, at the end of those couple of weeks, if you do that consistently and you don't, you know, you do that to the exclusion of anything else, just for 30 minutes a day, at the end of those 2 weeks, you're going to know more about YouTube than I do. You know, you're going to know more about YouTube than pretty much most people on the planet know, because most people are dotting around all these different areas. So because you then know more than most people know, there's a value associated to that. And people will be willing to pay you money to learn the things that you've learned in that time in an accelerated format. Does that make sense? Yeah.
Yeah. Especially in this area, especially in internet marketing. I think that's probably the easiest area to create something in, because you have a gigantic audience and nobody knows where to begin. And it's true that there will be 5% of the world who knows more than you do. So that means you only have 95% of the world to market your product to, you know, so it makes sense. You pick an area, you can become knowledgeable about that area to the point where, yeah, you would know more than I do about YouTube. And I have 40,000 YouTube subscribers and I've been doing YouTube for many years. But if you were reading about how to rank a video highly on YouTube, you would know way more than I do about that, just with the 2 weeks of effort. So that then becomes the basis for people maybe wanting to listen to you, wanting to join your list, and so on and so forth. Now, at the same time, I will say that even though I created a product of my own, it was a hard slog, definitely.
Right.
But also in the internet marketing area, I haven't really created any products. And I even asked you this on Voxer. I said, it seems like all the cool people have their own products and I just promote other people's products as an affiliate. But it just seems like so much work and I'm just not sure the results would justify it. I mean, and you basically came back with, you said, I'm a big believer in just doing more of what works. And what's working for you right now is being an affiliate. So maybe given the 27 things you'd have to master to create your own thing, maybe you just keep doing what you're doing. And I took that as pretty good advice. You've noticed there have been no product launches by Tom Woods, so you know I have listened to Chaney.
Yeah. No, that is the easiest way for people to get started, is to be an affiliate, is just to take products that already exist, connect them with a market that already exists, and just get paid the reward to do it. You're not having to create anything. You're not having to become that expert. You don't have to put all the research in. You don't have to go off and lock yourself away in a laboratory and the product factory and slave away for months on end creating this thing. You know, you just find a market that wants something, that doesn't know where it is or how to find it, get the product, find the product that already exists, introduce the two, and just get paid all the money. I mean, that's affiliate marketing in essence. And it's, you know, it's a great way for people to get started. And as you've seen yourself, you don't need to move beyond that. I mean, you can generate, you know, huge amounts of income just by doing that.
Well, I've also been successful basically by observing what other people do and seeing if any of it is something that I could plausibly replicate. And my favorite example of this is a guy named Pat Flynn, who has the Smart Passive Income podcast. And I saw he's one of these people who does an income report every month of what his income and outgo.
Oh, yeah.
And his income every month is showing tens of thousands of dollars a month just from promoting web hosting services, particularly Bluehost, which I like. And I thought, what the heck? Tens of thousands a month? What is with that? I thought, look, I don't need tens of thousands a month, but that's an interesting thing to do. So I thought, well, if I were to do that, if I were to get in on that particular affiliate program, what would I do to sweeten the deal so that people would want to get hosting through me? And why would they want to seek out my link? So I thought, well, what can I do to help them? And what's the thing that people, what's the pain point when you start a website from scratch? The main thing is no one's going to visit that website. That's the problem. Well, I have a podcast with a lot of listeners. If you get your hosting through my link, I'll mention your site on my show to my whole audience.
Right,
I'll give you a backlink on my website, which is very highly ranked in Google, or I'll give you some free tutorials, or I even created a Facebook group, private group for people who use my link whenever they have a technical issue or they want to help each other or get help. They have a private group for that. These are amazing bonuses. And so I got that basically from not quite copying somebody. I got the original idea from him, but the bonuses were entirely my idea. But that's really what this is all about. Maybe you get a little bit of inspiration from somebody, and then you make it your own.
Yeah. I mean, that happens all the time. And everybody's doing that. You know, you've got to have your eyes open to what is working. And as you say, model it. We're not talking about copying, outright copying, you know, not copying wording or copying bonuses, or it's just, okay, well, how have they done that? Like, how does that actually work? let's break this down. Why is that successful? Okay, successful because they've hit on the pain points. So they've spoken about the frustration that people face when they're buying that product. Then they've delivered, they've kind of plugged the holes of that product. So as you said, with hosting, the kind of hole in that is, well, yeah, but I could create a website, sure, but nobody's ever going to visit it, or it's going to be hard to set it up. And you've just, yeah, you've done the classic thing with bonuses. You've plugged the holes. And you said, well, yeah, that is true. But when you buy through my link, I'll plug that gap for you because I'll help you get traffic and I'll help you set the website up, you know, give you resources or whatever. So yeah, it's you know, it's a big thing, particularly in internet marketing, is looking what's working out there. And as we said, just going back to what I said earlier, leveraging other people's expertise and experience, you know, people that have already hacked their way through this jungle and come out the other side, rather than you saying, well, actually, no, I'm going to do it my own way here. I'm going to go through this thorny bush over here and I'm actually going to, you know, end up in a pitfall. Well, no, just look at the path that's already been cleared, the path of least resistance, and just, you know, follow in the footsteps of, you know, proven success.
You also talk about less is more. And without my putting my editorial comment on that, can you elaborate on what less is more means?
Well, it's kind of, yeah, it's related to what you said earlier as well about the, you know, when you were asking me, should I do a product launch? Really trying to do as little as you can and get a maximum output. So it's, you know, about maximum output for the least amount of effort. It goes back to what we said earlier about people on this kind of hamster wheel, you know, as entrepreneurs thinking they've got to do everything, you know, they've got to be the bottle washer, they've got to be, you know, the chief cook, you know, they've got to be, have like eight arms and do all these different things. I'm a big believer in just finding something that works and just doing the bajings out of it, you know, just getting so good at that one thing that you don't need all the other stuff. You don't need all the extra stuff. Like, you know, you see all these gadgets coming out and bits of software, you know, little chat bots, you know, that have a little chat on your screen, or a little, you know, attention grabber, or put a post-it note on your website, or add a little video character to your website, or, you know, add, you know, a video sales letter that, you know, all these different things. And yeah, these individually, these are all great tools. But if you go down that rabbit hole of saying, okay, let me have a look at that, let me try and do that, and let me try and master that, you'll master none of them. You know, somebody was asking me the other day, they said, oh, you know, what? How do I market on Instagram? I said, I've got no freaking idea. I don't have an Instagram account. I don't use Instagram. I don't use LinkedIn. I rarely use Twitter. You know, as an internet marketer making, you know, millions plus dollars a year, people might be like, what? Like, how could you not use Twitter? How could you not use Instagram? I'm focused. Yeah, I don't want to be doing extra stuff. I don't want to overburden myself and have to learn stuff and try and become an expert in more things. As soon as you find something that works and you get that traction with and you start getting some momentum, that's it. You are in the zone with that. Just stick with that. And going back to, you know, paralleling back to the cycling, when I first started with my coach, I think about 3 years ago now, before I'd even competed in a single race, he said, well, why are you doing this? And I said, I want a time trial. I want to do those races where you're on your own. It's you versus the clock. You've got that special time trial bike and it's basically you and the clock and you're in your own head and you're going as fast as you can. And I'd never done that. I'd never done any type of race. And he's like, are you sure? Why don't you, you know, you should probably try out and do a little bit of mountain bike racing, maybe do some cross country races, maybe do some road races. And I was like, no, that is what I want to do. And that is what I'm going to specialize in. So all my time is geared towards that one discipline. You know, I'm not trying to become, you know, kind of satisfactory in all these other different disciplines. I want to become excellent in this one area. So that's really what less is more is about. And it applies not just to the cycling, but also to business and internet marketing, especially because there's so many things flying around internet marketing all the time that people kind of get bombarded and overwhelmed thinking, do I have to do all this stuff? Do I need a blog? Do I need a YouTube? Do I need Facebook? Do I need LinkedIn? Do I need Twitter? Do I need Instagram? No, you can make excellent money, millions of dollars without all of those things. As long as you've got something that works, you don't need all the bells and whistles. So it's, yeah, it's really just about focusing in on one kind of path, if you like, and just sticking to that and not getting distracted from it.
What you just said is exactly what the American copywriter Bob Bly tells his list all the time, because they're worried about, well, would I be able to maintain in my business a Facebook page and a Twitter account and Instagram and Pinterest and whatever? And he says, look, I don't even know what half these things even are. And I earn, you know, $1 zillion a year. It doesn't matter to me. He says, the key thing is if there are a couple of things you enjoy doing, do those couple of things, but don't feel like you have to have a presence all over the place on the internet, because you absolutely don't. And then secondly, on this less is more thing, one neat thing about internet marketing that I have not seen in any other niche is that I can buy the rights to something. I can buy the rights to sell, let's say, sell a course and keep all the profits for myself, because I've already paid the product creator for the right to do that. So just to give an example, I bought a course, a really, really top quality course, probably 115 short videos on all the sorts of things you'd want to know when getting started online, just everything from the basics of setting up your website all the way through to joining different affiliate programs and learning cPanel and all these sorts of things. And you could find this stuff online, true, if you want to make yourself insane chasing videos around Google all day long. But I've got it all there for you systematically, and it's great. It's a course created by Paul Counts. I know you know him.
Yeah.
And it cost me $97 to buy the rights to be able to resell that course and keep all the profits. I've turned that around into $35,000 from that $97 investment. Could you imagine? I don't think I would have survived making 115 videos. Okay. there would have been bodies all over the floor. It would have been a disaster. So less is more. I just thought, well, I don't want to do that, but I do want to be able to provide this information to people who rely on my advice. So I'll buy Paul's course. They're all going to love it, which they all have. I've heard nothing but good things about it. And that saved me a huge amount of effort, because if somebody else has done it and it's at least as good as anything I could have made, well, if you can't beat them, join them.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And as I say, when I first started out, none of this stuff really existed, because there were just so few people out there doing this in this industry and teaching methods that they certainly weren't prepared, even if they were aware of the idea of giving rights away and a license away to resell their material. So there weren't any shortcuts like that around when I started out. So my only option was to go off and learn it all myself and create my own programs, you know, which is why now I've got these 9 different product funnels that I've got within multiple products inside each one, is because I've created these things from scratch to deliver into the marketplace that, you know, fulfill the needs of the, you know, the internet marketing crowd. But yeah, I mean, the shortcut, you know, if it was available to me back then, I would have taken it and would have, you know, bitten your arm off to do that, because you don't have to go and create it all, do the research and create the videos and everything else. So you just become this, yeah, like a conduit, a kind of a, you know, a deliverer of information that's already been created by somebody else. It's, you know, it's the perfect solution.
Well, of course, Michael, if you're interested in what Michael does and how he does it and exactly what this means, that you take what's already there and you just use it for yourself, which is exactly what I've done. As I said, with that course, I don't want to create 115 videos. So I spent $97 and I kept my sanity, and I don't want to create a whole string of products. So I promote Michael's. I mean, things like that. It makes my life a lot easier, more peaceful. I'm with my family a heck of a lot more than if I were up here slaving away, cursing like a sailor, making videos. And I forgot to turn the sound on, and it's just my mouth moving and nothing's coming out, whatever. Well, anyway, we are going to do a live training session together on April 18th of this year, 2018. That's a Wednesday at 3 p.m. Eastern. Sign up for it at TomWoods.com/Michael. Now, Michael has a gift for you if you show up and follow along. First of all, it's going to be a lot of fun. So, I mean, how could Michael not be fun? You're going to enjoy that. Stay through to the end. Michael has a gift, but I have a gift too. And my gift is I've made a video, lengthy one, where I take you behind the scenes of my own online businesses. And I show you exactly what I'm doing and how I'm doing it. I show you the tools I use. I show you the strategies I use. I show you how I drive traffic, all the technical ins and outs. I use this to do this. I use that to do that. If that doesn't sound valuable to you, I don't know. I don't know. I give up. I throw in the towel. But that is a valuable bonus. And all you have to do to get it, now, I'm not selling that. You can't buy it from me. You can't get it from me in any way other than by attending on April 18th at 3 p.m. Eastern, sticking through the whole presentation, and then we'll send that off to you. So that's the bonus of all bonuses. And so tomwoods.com/Michael is the sign-up page. Are we forgetting anything?
Can I get that as well, please?
Yeah, oh, sure, I'd be glad to send that to you, because that's what you need is more advice.
I will be. Well, no, I don't know everything you're doing. You might laugh at that, but I'm serious. I've seen your results and the amount of income you're bringing in with affiliate marketing. I'm like, I want to see this. So,
oh, well, okay. Yeah, you got it.
Obviously, I will be attending the training myself, as you know. So.
That's right. So if, as long as you stay through all the way to the end, Michael, we'll make sure.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I'll probably do that. Yeah, otherwise, it
don't forget that. If it just cuts out, that wouldn't really work. All right. Anyway, look, it's fun talking to you. And the thing is, with you, I don't have to say, listen, I know I got to rush you off the phone because you have a million things to do. You know, maybe you're going to go cycling, maybe you're going to hang out with the kids. And that's exactly what I love about this conversation. And in particular, these days, if somebody gets on the phone with me and says, listen, Tom, I know you're busy, but I almost take that, I know they don't mean it as an insult, but right, I almost right. take that as an insult. Like, I don't know how to manage my life properly, that I must be uniquely busy and frenetic, but I'm really not. And so I gently correct them and I say, well, actually, I'm not really that busy, but I appreciate that you're considerate about my time, but I'm really not that busy. And that's a deliberate choice on my part. Well, anyway, on that beautiful note, I remind people tomwoods.com/Michael is the place to sign up because you're going to get a really great bonus. You're going to have a very interesting presentation. And, you know, you don't want to miss that. April 18th, but register immediately. Get over there and register immediately at tomwoods.com/Michael. All right, Michael, get back to riding your bike or doing whatever it is you do, and thanks so much for your time.
Will do. We'll see you on the call.
All right, everybody, you are not going to want to miss those bonuses, especially my bonus, which is just going to be great. You get to see behind the scenes of everything I do, how I do it, what tools I use to do it. You may be able to get some tips for yourself there, or some maybe you'll get some ideas, because a lot of my ideas came from watching what other people do and then adapting those things to my personal situation. So how to get that? Well, make sure and join Michael and me together at that event on April 18th, but sign up as soon as possible so you don't forget. Sign up over at tomwoods.com/Michael, and I'll see you next week.
Become a smarter libertarian in just 30 minutes a day. Visit tomwoods.com to subscribe to the show for free, and we'll see you next time.